Hello everyone, and welcome to Game Break, the full coverage writer's presentation where we take a few moments out of our productive days to unwind with some video games, and perhaps find some newfound inspiration. Or in this case, for this game, I feel we should instead appreciate or take a chance to appreciate the interesting levels of creativity that went into this game. What game is this? Why, this is Rayman Legends, the most recent Rayman game that came out actually probably a couple years ago. I just recently got it and have been having a lot of fun with it because there's just so much to do. And in my personal opinion, this game has just been perfectly executed in every way, shape, and form. But that's just me rambling on about it. You also notice anyone familiar with Rayman will see I'm not playing as Rayman. I could. There are plenty of heroes to choose from. And of course, Rayman is one of them. But I've been enjoying these little... There he is. Hey, Rayman. I've been enjoying these little warrior barbarian princesses. So I'm playing as Sibylla. Because I feel like it. So there. But enough of that nonsense. I'm going to show off this game. Because it's amazing and deserves to be shown off. As you can see, I've made a lot of progress in this game already, but we're just going to go to the beginning and replay some of the low-level areas. There's not much plot to this game. Basically, these little teensy guys have been kidnapped by evil monstrosities, and they must be rescued. You can see on top of the painting up here, it keeps track of... Oops, I guess we're going in. Oop, get the health. Get the extra health. Haha. Yes, it keeps track of how many teensies you've captured and how many lums you've collected. Where are the teensies, you ask? Hidden! Yay! They're hidden everywhere. There are 10 in each level, as well as a ridiculously large amount of, lums. These are lums. If I could get the blue ones, they're worth double, but I, screwed up the order in grabbing those. Now this is just the tutorial level, so it will be easy, and I honestly don't know why the turnips, but I'm not asking. They give me lums. And sometimes those aren't turnips, sometimes they're bad guys. Like those ne'er-do-wells. Ah, these are special lums, special teensies. There are a queen and king teensy hidden each level. Oh, I missed one. Oh, I missed one again. There we go. Gotcha! They're a little golden in here because I've already rescued them, but if it was the first time, they'd look like that. I already have extra health. This game is doesn't really have health. It has, oh dear. If you get hit, you die, and you go back to the last checkpoint. But see, that little heart is an extra hit, and you can have up to one of those. I'm gonna need help with this guy. I'm gonna call in my friend, Murphy. Hey, Murphy. Some levels, Murphy gets to pop in and, helps us get past the levels. I forget if there's anything over here. Nope. Alright, no hidden secrets. And away we go! Just everything about these games I love. The gameplay itself is amazing. The art is amazing. The music is amazing. It's silly. It's fun. Sure, it's just a platformer. But it's a really fun little platformer. Whoa! And I do recommend, I'm playing it on the PC, obviously. If you do play it on the PC, and it is available on Steam, do yourself a favor and get yourself a game controller. You don't want to play this game with a keyboard. I tried. Thanks, Murphy. It is much more fun with a game controller. Of course, since this is the first level, it's the tutorial level, so it's going to be telling me how to do everything all the way through. Blink, blink. And we're going to wake up those lums. If you grab the blue one, the next one in line turns blue, and the blue ones are worth double. And you can go die. And I'll rescue that teensy. Let Murphy open that. Cut the rope. Wouldn't be a platformer without rope swings. Oh, sneaky, sneaky. Yeah, if you jam through these levels a bit too quickly, you can sometimes doom the teensies to a horrific death. We don't want to do that. That would be bad. Oh yeah, he needs to, whoa, I almost crushed myself. And you can float a little bit, which is fun. You can bounce off the bad guys Mario style. Hey, up and die. Gonna have you rotate that. Take out this little gremly goblin-y guy, and we'll redo this Rescue the King because it gets me more lums. Oh, and this one was just fun and interesting. So, we have to get over to the other side. Without dying. Don't want to die. Like I said, this one may not seem like much because it is, whoa, just the first level. But they do get really complicated later on. There were levels later on where you have to avoid moving lights or you take damage. Sometimes the teensies, you only have a limited amount of time to rescue them before they're just gone. Ooh, did a little roll there. Some rather complicated platforming comes into this game. It is a lot of fun in these earlier levels. In the later levels, yeah, those coins give you a whole bunch of lums, but you have to get them away from the starting point and carry them for a certain amount of time. If you take damage, you lose them and you have to grab them again. Help me! You always know where there's a... Whew. You can always tell where there's a teensy because they will call for help. That was an evil witch goblin thing, not a turnip. I don't know why for the turnips. I never really played any of the older... lols. Any of the previous Rayman games. But this one, I know like one of the earlier Rayman games was a 3D platformer? PlayStation, I think? Don't quote me on that. I could be horribly, horribly wrong. Bring that down. I do like the Murphy levels because Murphy gets to do some interesting things. There's one level where you have to have him spread guacamole on the ground to create pathways for you. Alright, sneak through you. Have him tickle this big guy here. And good night. And hey, it's the end of the level. Look at all those rescued teensies. That's the other thing, just beating the levels is fun because they make it so fun. And of course, then there's little how many lums did you get? From what I can see, from what I've seen, they usually break it up into four parts. You can't see it here, but each level also has at the third tier in between silver and gold, a lucky ticket. Which, if you get it, it's a scratch-off ticket that unlocks more lums, you can rescue a teensy, you can unlock creatures, and you can unlock origin levels. Because everything's through paintings, because in the old platforming sense, everybody loves traveling through paintings. And so you rescue heroes, the lums, it's just, you need so many lums. Rescuing teensies unlocks the main levels, but unlocking lums can unlock additional characters, and they do get expensive, as you can see, including the most expensive 1 million lum character. Not really much of a difference between the characters, they all play the same, which is nice. It's more of a personal aesthetic preference, which I actually think is better. Then you can just enjoy playing the game. They also have weekly and daily challenges, which you can see in the bottom, there's leaderboards. This is some kind of multiplayer thing. I have not played that. But they also have the origins. You have the main story all the way over to the right. But to the left, you have the origin stories, which I should have looked into this. But I think these are levels from previous Rayman games that have been revamped for this game, and you can only unlock them with the lucky tickets. And same with that, there are the creatures, which are just fun. They can only be unlocked with lucky tickets. There's a bunch of them. And every day they give you lums! Oh, look at all the lums. Oh, so many lums. Oh, give me all of the lums. Thank you, my little creature friends. My little frogs. My robot friends. My balloon friends? Yay, it's the balloons. Okay, give me that lum. Yay, the toasts. The little toast friends. More lums for me. The ghosts. We have the toasts. We have the ghosts. And lastly, we have the pigs. Oh, thank you for all the lums, my friends. Thank you very much. And every day, those will reset, and you'll have even more lums to collect. And every time you play a level again, even though you can only rescue the teensies once, you can get more and more lums as you want every time. But enough of that, back to showing off the awesome levels. I'm normally only going to show some from the first world, and I don't know if I'm going to do this. As you play through the game, each world has its own unique enemies. This one has those weird little witch things. But eventually the levels will be invaded by enemies from other levels. That skeleton guy is from the third level. This frog thing is from the second level. And this is where you rescue the princesses. These are fun too. So yeah, as you progress through, different worlds become unlocked. These ones are tough though. You're timed to get to the end, and the longer you take, the more teensies you lose. And this one, I had to beat it in under 40 seconds in order to rescue all three. I beat it in like 41 seconds. And that was on my second attempt. And that's just shenanigans. And I don't like it. Oop, give me the extra health. Every level lets you get one of those. Every level that lets you have extra health. Because some levels don't let you have extra health. Hey, look, another one. Teensy! Gotta be quick with those sometimes or they go away. Anything down here? Nope. Anything? Hey, found some lums. There's stuff hidden everywhere. Come on. Oh, I thought the thing was gonna fall. Oh, it's a... There it goes. There it is. It's pressure plate. So we don't have to trigger those. Boink. Bink. Bonk. More lums. And of course, these are the really early levels, so they're really easy. But getting on towards the end, they get very challenging. Oops. Actually, there's an achievement. Oh, I can't do it with this guy because that thing will get me. Woo! I think I can do it with you. There's an achievement to just stand on this until he attacks me. Come on, do something. There we go! Achievement! Haha! So suddenly this is an achievement guide. Not. Get rid of you, get rid of you, and any... Aha! Secrets up here! Oh, these are interesting. See where the spikes are. Remember where the spikes are. Do you remember where the spikes are? There we go. There's a whole bunch of these and they're really tricky. Well, some of the later ones are really tricky. The last level I played where I actually got stuck to the point where I gave up, I was trying to rescue one of those, and... it was a pain in the ass. You had to, use wall runs and jumps to get through spinning blades while fire chased you, and the up and down controls were reversed. So, up was down and down was up. Uh-oh. We're gonna have to wait for that to let another pass. I will get that coin. I'm too much of a completionist to not get the coin. Boink! Like I said, you can just bounce right off enemy heads, run past that, and on to the next. Out of my way, bones! Oh, hello, you. Those things are nasty. They grab you with their eye, hand, arms, and then eat your face. No, go away. And you go away. Alright, which I think down was the secret. There's a secret down here. And yes, there's unlimited air, so you can stay underwater forever, which comes in handy later on because there's an entire world that has a lot of underwater levels, which are really cool. Hey, you leave them alone. Oh, that's how I get up there. Rescue you. Slaughter you. Ow. Oh, he took away one of my things. Oh yeah, so I got a wall jump up here. Maybe? Oh no, I got a... Oh, I guess I do have to... Oh, there it is. Hey you, hidden behind the walls. I found you. And I found the king. Hello, king. Don't get nommed. Don't get nommed. Gotcha! It's just so much fun to play these games. And I love the art style. I love, like, the cartoony art style to it. I just love the feel of it. It's fun to play. It's fun to explore. It has that whole... If you're, like, a completionist like me who likes the challenge... Because you can beat these levels pretty easily without getting everything... But if you want to get everything, it challenges you. And the challenge is good. Like, whoa, whoa, no, 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 no. I just want the coin. No, 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 no. Cool. Oh, I heard a help me. There you are. Getcha. Fortunately, since I've already played this level, I can't keep track of which ones I've gotten as easily and which ones I've missed. Because there are, on that little meter on the top of the screen that shows up, can I show it? Is there a button to show? No. Or there might be, and I'm just not hitting it. But it'll let you know if you miss one, because you'll... They're, with the exception of the king and queen, they're sequential. Alright, so we need to go... Oh! No, I missed one! You can die, you can die. And we'll just make our way down here. There's nothing hidden down here, is there? No! Okay, good. Don't get munched. Kill the weird heart thing. Make our way down. Boing, boing. See, that's one of those tricky ones where you can screw up, because there's no way of knowing that guy's up there in advance. So if you just kill those things instead of bouncing off their heads, then you miss out on saving that teensy. Oh, here we go. Come on, reset. Keep your grabby hands away from me, you ugly monster thing. Boing! Hey, I missed one. Oh, moving things. That's right. Nope, I want to go down. Because there's a coin here. And I feel like there... Nope, I can't get through there. Because that vine will hurt me. That is not decorative. Not decorative at all. There we go. And we're out! Hooray! Another successful run of a level I've already done. That's just because I'm showing off how fun these levels are and how cool this game is. I don't want to... play through a level that I'm completely stuck on. We can speed that up. And then, not be able to show you anything cool and just show you me dying repeatedly. Which is no fun. No fun at all. We don't want to do that. And still not up to 100,000 lums. Let's see, what's another fun level? Oh, I'll show off a rescue mission first, and then we'll get to some more interesting things. Ooh, I have an uncompleted level over here. Maybe I should do these. Real quick though, let's take a look at a rescue level. Some of these are a little different, but most of them are pretty fun. You will get one shot to make it through the level, and there are three Teensies hidden in this level. And it's a Murphy level! Hey Murphy! Get your sweet smile over here and help me get through this dungeon. Boing! Hmm. Ah. That's what it does. That's better. And I just realized that there's fire chasing me. Sort of fire chasing me. Oh! Well, I borked it. Oh, I borked it again. It gets a little tricky with Murphy because sometimes I get confused about which one's me and which one's Murphy. Murphy needs to bring that down, bring that down, get past the ghostlies. Get over there. Cut that rope. Cut that rope. Make those go away. Oh no, I missed it. Welp, I'm not getting that one. And I'm dying! Maybe I'll get another chance to get him. Ooh, I will. There we go. That's how you do it. See, these levels, they can get a little tricksy on you. Especially with Murphy, because you gotta figure out when you want to touch, when you want Murphy to do his thing, when you don't want Murphy to do his thing, and it's an extra button on the controller you have to hit that you normally... Oh, shazzle butt. I wasn't supposed to hit that one. And it brought us back to here. Hit him! Good enough. I'm getting all confused. And go down, kill the fire dude, bounce around, kill you, cut you. Run under you, cut you, run under you. Ah, wasn't supposed to cut that one yet. Get you down. Get you down. Oh no! Come on, come on, come on! Ah! These are tricksy! When you're trying to, that's how you do that. Get that down. Get that down. Kill you. Get rid of you. Get rid of you. I missed my jump. Where's it gonna put me? Oh, it's gonna put me back here. Oh, but I screwed it up. You get unlimited lives at least. Unlimited lives. I keep going off the edge though, and that's bad. Alright. And part of it is because the fire does chase you. So you are somewhat timed to get through this. It doesn't, like, super chase you. Oops. Alright, screw you. I can actually probably just hit that guy as I pass through. But because... Let me see if I can just... Oh yeah, I can just do that. I don't even need to take my time. The other thing is I'm running when I could be walking. So, I might be rushing things. Get rid of those. Get rid of those. Get under that. There we go. Well, that was Trixie. You got to see me die a couple times. Woo! But it's a little bit different, and there's a whole bunch of levels like that. I'm just going to speed this up and get to... Oh, I was short. I was short. Like, 11 lums. 11 lums. Oh, well. It happens. What-what-ta-pa-po. Oh, well. I'm apparently missing a couple here. Now, this is interesting because this is towards the end of the world. And whenever they do this, there's a pre-boss level that introduces the boss, followed by the boss level. Gimme. How to shoot your dragon. Oh, I think this one gives me the super fist, too, which does let me shoot fireballs. Alright, so we're missing a couple... Grab that. And grab that. And get rid of you. And call in Murphy. Hey, Murph. How you doing, pal? I need that up, please. Thank you. Bring it back down. You see anything up there? No? Okay. Get that out of the way. Get rid of you. Oh, look at you! I already have this one, but... There we go. There's a couple I missed, including, I think, the king. So we're going to have to keep our ears open for the help me's, which I'm hearing. There it is. I'm not sure if I have this one yet or not. I don't remember this one. I don't have this one. This one's interesting, though. Not incredibly difficult, but interesting. There we go, I got the queen. Yay! Another teensy rescued. Alright. And move over here. Kill you. Get you down, and I think that fire stays, so we'll just go over that. I'll take that. I don't think there's anything down there. Looks like death. We want to avoid death and fire, and just focus on rescuing the teensies like you. Because I think I didn't have a gold trophy for this level either, and rescuing teensies also gets me lums. Bring you down, and then up again, because the other rescue is here. I'll do it again for the lums. Oh, it's another one of these. Head down to here. Whoopsie. Rotate you. This one I remember. This one's definitely a little bit trickier than the last one. There we go. And around and down. Through the spikes. All the way back. Whoa, not that far. Not that far. That, whoa. And here. And here we go. Ha-ha! Another teensy re-rescued. Double rescued. Whatever. I re-rescued him. He is mine. Hooray! And now we go down. And I see there's another one I missed up here. Whoa. Let's see if I can't... There we go! Getcha! That should have been the third one. 4, 5, 6. I'm missing the 7th one. Fudge you. Get rid of you. Tickle you, and then murder you. Always give someone a good tickle before you give them a murder. Where do you get rid of you? Oh, look at that. Oops. Like I said, things get tricksy. And head back to rescue you. Oh, I missed. Gotta get right to the edge. There we go. And now we get back this way. Get rid of you. Hop over you. Oh dear, I gotta run. Oops! See, I think they give me a time limit there because I think fire chases me from those vents. The music certainly picks up. Oh yeah, fire's chasing. That's fire. Get that. Oh, I missed the coin! Oh, and I took damage. Tickle you. And then murder your face. Should be okay without having that coin. Okay, the music's still intense, so we have to keep going. Got you. Come on, come on. Those big guys only actually take one hit. Oops. Alright, skipping that coin. Bring that down. Whoa, 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 whoa. And down here. Oh, there was one up there. No going back now. Cut that. Get rid of that. Get over there. Leave that. Why would I want to cut that? I need that. Uh-oh. Oh, and... oh, that was the teensy I was missing. Okay. Oof. No need. Yeesh. That was the teensy I was missing. Oh, time to run. You evil teensy. Uh-oh. In a previous level, there is a level where you have to chase the evil teensy around to rescue a good teensy. This evil teensy has summoned dragons! Time to run. And I'm dead. Yes, yes, we just saw that. Fists of Fury! But this is the, I have the fist-throwing ability. Which is greatly needed. And that's it! Well, we got to add two teensies to the list, but we're still about 34 lums short of getting gold in this level, because we need 600. Better! But not perfect. But that's just how it goes sometimes. Yep, that's it. So close. So close. But as you can see, fun yet challenging. And the skulls on the bottom of the painting determine the difficulty level. I think it goes up to 5, maybe 6. Like I said, this is the pre-boss level, and then this is the boss level, which I'm not going to do right now. And you may be wondering to yourself, but if this is the boss level, what's that level over there? The boss is the end of the world. When you beat the boss, the world is done. But wait, there's another painting, after the boss painting, that only unlocks when you beat the boss. What is it? These are probably my favorite levels in the game. Each world has one of these, like, post-boss battle epilogue games that are just brilliant. They're my favorite. These are my fun favorite to do. And I want to show them off to the full potential. In order to do that, I am, one, hopefully not going to die on this level. I should be able to do it without dying. It's only a 2-skull level. But I think what I'm going to need to do is actually turn up the in-game sound effects and music. Hopefully it won't be too loud. And mute my microphone for this level. Just so it can be enjoyed to its full potential. Here we go. Oh, those levels always make me smile. Always. Turn that back down for now. Oh, always make me smile. I can't help but not smile while playing those levels. And that is exactly what these video games should do. They don't necessarily need a great story if the gameplay is great and inventive and just fun like that. Every time I play those levels, and every one of these worlds over here has a final level that's just like that, where you play to the music. At least I assume so. I obviously have yet to unlock Living Dead Party, but I haven't finished Olympus Maximus yet, so I'm assuming that by the time I finish that, I'll have the 18 more teensies I need to get in there, and if not, as can be seen, there are plenty missing from the previous worlds, and I think I'm still missing a couple from the Origin worlds. So, I think that's going to cut it here for showing off how truly inventive and creative this game is. Maybe I'll even finish off by pulling Rayman out of the works. Hey, Rayman. I said, hey, Rayman. I don't play with you at all, but this is your game. Woo! Fudge to that. I want one of my barbarian princesses. I'm here. It's tricky to get in the paintings. At least the way I do it. I'm probably doing it the hard way, but whatever. Like I said, all the characters play the same, but yeah, this game is just, there's not much plot to it, but it's just so much fun, and it plays so well. And even the levels that I'm having trouble in towards the end, in this level, in this world, it's just because they're really tricky. They're not poorly designed, it's just they're really, I mean, this is a 5-star, a 5-skull level difficulty area. This is as hard as it gets, with probably the exception of this. So this is as hard as it's getting for me right now, and it's proving to be the case, but it's still a lot of fun. And I highly recommend, if you get the chance, to try and pick up this game, even if you've never played a Rayman game before. It's just a lot of fun, it's relaxing. I think there's a multiplayer mode you can play with up to 4 people, cooperatively, and versus. It's available on everything, on the Xbox, on the PlayStation, on the Wii, and obviously through Steam on the PC. It's a lot of fun, there's a lot of fun achievements to go for. If you're into the Uplay achievements by Ubisoft, it has a couple of those. I just highly recommend it. And even if you beat the entire game, you still have the daily and weekly challenges that you can do. So it has a lot of fun replayability, and I just highly recommend it. And that's it for this episode of Game Break. If you enjoyed watching this video and are interested in this game, like, comment, and subscribe below for more from us at Full Coverage Writers. And until next time, get out there, be creative, and be awesome.